Please welcome Harvard Professor of Ethnic Cleansing, Ferris McGee, Wolf Blitzer, Clint Eastwood, and former Governor of Colorado, Ernest Grover. They'll be having the election results tonight. We'll be getting the first results from Indiana and Kentucky at any moment now, despite the fact that the voter turnout in Indiana has reached record lows because people generally don't live there. So, let's go over to our reporter, Ken Struggle, who's standing over there because he has some wicked BO. Ken?
All right, so despite the low voter turnout...
Get on with the results!
So despite the low voter turnout in Indiana, the results are still at the standard tie, with Megan Farrell of the Wholesome Tommy Party getting 3,000,001 votes, and Sora Bundy's of the Nurse Ambassador Party, 4! But the Senate race is still tight, with the Jason Mayhew of the Wholesome Tommy Party gaining on Henry Krusty McGill of the Memphis Ambassador Party.
Well, you can say goodbye to Indiana then. What do you make of these results, Ferris?
I went to Harvard.
My thoughts exactly.
Well, my prediction was wrong in that the Wholesome Tommy Party won. Ernest?
Winning Indiana brings the Wholesome Tommy Party this much closer to having their electoral cake and eating it too. I'm just waiting for it to happen so I can complain about being in the wrong generation. Wolf?
More on that later, Ernest. We're going to have to throw it over to Ken with the results.
Okay, that's my job!
Alright, so the results from Kentucky are in!
You just took my job! You bastard!
That's a lot of numbers in four!
Victory for Bundy's. Way to hold it all in there, Bundy's. What do you make of this, Ferris?
Wait, but aren't there still well over 3 million votes left to count?
Shut up, Clint.
Another prediction of mine shattered as I thought that Kentucky, given the peculiarities of some of its citizens, would vote blue. Ernest?
This is to be expected. Bundy's vision of Utopia was especially appealing to Kentuckians. But as we all know, Utopia exists only in the minds of children, political idealists, and Stone Poli-Sci undergraduates.
I'm sorry about you, Ernest, but there's been a development in Kentucky. The other 3,512,345 votes have gone to Albert 7 Petroff, the independent candidate.
Wolf, what are you doing?
Albert 7 Petroff thus becomes the first independent candidate to win a state's popular vote with such a shitty name.
Can you stop interrupting me, please, Wolf? There's an established order here.
I'm sorry, Chuck.
So you won't interrupt me?
No.
There's no new development to cut me off with?
Absolutely.
Good.
Hold on, I'm getting worse. There's been a dramatic turnaround in the Senate polls in Indiana. Henry Krusty Magellan has pulled away and won the Senate in Indiana.
Ken, he's stealing your job now!
Senator Krusty Magellan will take over the office from the standing Senator Thuban Thunderthighs at the end of his term.
Senator Krusty at the Senate?!
Folks, the election's really beginning.
But we have the results from two states!
Actually, the results from Virginia...
The results from Virginia are in. And they have voted in favor of Millenova over Michigan by 8 points.
What about Georgia, damn it?
Georgia has finished their Senate polling and have elected unanimously to represent them of Curtis Persteca, that is, a Georgia peach that goes by the name of Doug Summers.
First Lawrence to run for office. Somebody better check his birth certificate.
Oh, it's not the first March thing.
That's true. Clint Abercott did run for governor of New Hampshire in 2008, but his campaign was put on hold indefinitely when he was accidentally eaten.
Okay, everybody, shut up! Please, dear God, the point of election night is there to be undue panic, not legitimate chaos.
Sorry, dude!
Whoa! Okay, we're going to cut to commercial break. Hopefully, when we come back, we can get through the night without a peach, an apricot, or a fucking cup of ramen becoming president of the United States.
We'll be back after these.
Whoa!